أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الفرد الواحد الأحد الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفؤاً أحدا. خلق وبرى، خلق الماء والثرى، وأبدع كل شيء خلقه وذرى. لا يغيب عن بصره صغير النمل في الليل إذا سرى، ولا يعذب عن علمه مثقال ذرة في الأرض ولا في السماء. خلق آدم فاجتباه ثم ابتلاه ثم تاب عليه وهداه، وأرسل نوحا فصنع الفلك وجرى، ونجى الخليل إبراهيم من نار شديدة الالتهاب، فصار حرها بردا وسلاما عليه، فاعتبروا بما جرى. أرسل موسى بمعجزات فما ادكر فرعون وما وعى، وأيد عيسى بمعجزات تبهر الورى، وأرسل الحبيب محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم بالكتاب تبيانا وهدى ورحمة للورى. أحسن تدبير الكائنات، قدر الأرزاق والأقوات، أنزل الماء من المعصرات، وأثاب على الأعمال الصالحات. أمرنا مولانا بأن لا نلغي بأنفسنا إلى المهالك، وأن لا نستوحش طرق الهدى لقلة السالك الهالك، وأن لا نتبع طريق الضلالة لكثرة السالك. فكل ما يخطر في بالك فهو خلاف ذلك، فهو أكبر وأعظم وأجل من ذلك. هو الله ربي لا إله إلا هو الفرد الواحد الخالق. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد طب القلوب ودوائها، وعافية الأبدان وشفائها، ونور الأبصار وضيائها، صلاة سرمدية أبدية إلى يوم الدين ثم أما بعد. My dear respected brother and sister in Islam, I bear witnesses and testify that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one and the only one to be worshipped. And I bear witnesses and testify that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is the last messenger and servant from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, inshallah, we're going to try to talk about a very sensitive and very important issues in Islam. We're going to try to talk about the salah, the prayer. I guess we all know the importance of the salah, but we cannot emphasize enough about the importance and the preciousness of the salah in Islam. At the beginning, if things mentioned in the Quran one time, I guess this is enough to indicate the importance of that things. But how about if these things mentioned in the Quran in every and each almost ayah in the Quran? It's a salah. When you read in Surah Al-Fatiha, اهدنا الصراط المستقيم. The صراط المستقيم and the hidayah, that means, oh Allah, show us the right road, the right path to go directly to you. And at the top of that road, it's a salah. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah, ألف لام ميم، أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، ألف لام ميم، ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه هدى للمتقين الذين يؤمنون بالغيب وَيُقِيمُونَ الصَّلَاةَ. Describing mu'min people, every time you find Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the mu'min people, He connect them with the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ كَانَتْ عَلَى الْمُؤْمِنِينَ كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا. If you look closely to the word that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chosen to talk about the salah, this is what tell you the importance of the salah. كِتَابًا مَوْقُوتًا, that means a written book over a Muslim people. Us as a human being, when we have something valuable, something precious, something important, we want to keep it, we don't want to forget about it, what do we do with it? We write it in a book. So even we write it for the next generation or next people that's coming behind us. Because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the salah, it's a written book in all mu'min and Muslim people. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in His book, حافظوا على الصلاة والصلاة الوسطى. And if you go through the Quran, you will see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep talking about the salah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, As-salatu imaduddin. The salah is the main corner of deen, of the Islam. فَمَنْ أَغَامَهَا فَقَدْ أَغَامَ الدِّينَ وَمَنْ تَرَكَهَا فَقَدْ هَدَمَ الدِّينَ. Whoever established the salah, established the whole deen. And whoever leave the salah, imagine what he's doing. He's destroying the deen. And imagine that the first things, that's when you die and go meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will be asking about, it's a salah. If your salah is good, the rest of your work is good. If the salah is not good, they're not even going to look at the rest of your work. Imagine things like that. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة صلاته فإن صلحت صلح سائر عمله وإن فسدت فسد سائر عمله. And the last wasiyah before Salat Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam die, he said, As-salah, 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 three times before he die. As-salah, as-salah, as-salah. If this was the salah, and this is what we supposed to be doing every and each time, imagine to emphasize about the importance of the salah. If you have a car, as examples, and you're taking this car to the dealer 5 times a day, the people that manufacture the cars, do you think that this car will have a problem with it? So when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala call you 5 times a day, this is a mandatory. This is the minimum time to keep maintaining yourself. And who's saying that? The one that's created you, the one that's manufactured you, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And to know the importance of the salah, we will go and look about some stuff. It's very close to you, but maybe you're not paying attention to it. First of all, I guess all of us, we know that Islam has 5 corners and 5 pillars in the Islam. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Testifying that Allah the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is a messenger from Allah. وَإِقَامُ الصَّلَاةِ, establishing the salah. وَإِتَاءُ الزَّكَاةِ, charity. صَوْمُ رَمَضَان, fasting رَمَضَان. وَحَجُّ الْبَيْتِ لِمَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا. Do the duty of pilgrims. But we have to pay attention. There is a difference between the corners of Islam and the corners of the Muslim. We all as a Muslim people, we have to believe on those five pillars of Islam. But as a Muslims, not all of us, we have to have those five corners on us. How? We come to shahada to Allah ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. This testify, it's enough. You saying it once in your lifetime. It's enough. And after that, leave the salah alone, the second. Go to the third one. Fast in Ramadan. If you are not able to fast Ramadan, and you're sick, and you're too old, and you cannot do Ramadan, then Ramadan is not a corner on you as a Muslim. But you have to believe on it. Then when you go to the charity, if I'm poor and I don't have money, the charity is not a corner on me as a Muslim. And if I don't have the ability to do the Hajj, it's not a corner on me. So what's left to you? Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa salah and the salah. Shahadatu an la ilaha illallah, we said it's enough once in your lifetime to say it. Then what left with you as a Muslim? The salah. Believe it or not, the salah, it's only one thing would never, ever, ever leave you till you go 6 feet down. And when you go down, it will never leave you. Your work will stop, but the salah, it will start working for you. Here, because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's amazing thing that you have to pay attention to it. When we're leaving every those five corners of Islam and we're doing only the salah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the salah combine all those five pillars of Islam inside the salah. Look how amazing is it. Number one, when you do the salah, you bring the first corner of Islam, shahadatu an la ilaha illallah wa anna Muhammad Rasulullah. In the tashahud, you testify that. That means in the salah, first you brought the first corner of Islam in the salah. Then the second corner is the salah, you're doing the salah itself. Then the charity, ita'u zakah. Let's go step by step. Where are you getting the money? Where do you pay the zakah from? From your work. And where are you getting the work from? From your time. Isn't so? Then on the salah, you're sacrificing the time. You're sacrificing the original, not the money, the time that you make the money from. And if you watch closely, in the zakah, you pay when the money has the whole year turn on it. And how much you pay? 2.5 out of your money. In the salah, you're sacrificing the whole time. Not 205 or 2.5 out of the money. No. The whole time. Then here, you're sacrificing not the money, the original. That you make the money to do the zakah. And go to Ramadan. What do you do in Ramadan when you're fasting? You stop from eating and drinking and stop the human desire. In the salah, you don't eat, you don't drink. Not this only, you can't talk, You can't run, you can't walk, you can't laugh. But in Ramadan, while you're fasting, you could talk, you could run, you could laugh, you could do anything. Then here, in the Salah, you're doing fasting more than what you do, ever you're doing it in Ramadan itself. Then, what do you do in Hajj? You face the Kaaba, you go around, you do the zikr. In the Salah, when you come, first things that you have to face, Baytullah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you do the dhikr, and you do the best dhikr that ever is there, which is the Quran. So subhanallah ta'ala, in the dhaka, you're doing the whole five corners of the Islams. Every day you're doing it. This is why the Salah was and will become and will go to be the most important things ever in Islam. And if you look closely, you will find that every and each order for us as a Muslim came to us from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Rasulihi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Every order in Islam came indirectly from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam through Jibreel, except the Salah came directly bil mubashara between Rabb Muhammad and Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It came directly between Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala picked up Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the ground all the way to the seven heaven to give him the salah. And the rest of order, millions orders for Islam, it came indirectly through Jibreel to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This is to show you the importance of the salah. Us as a human being in our life, if you have the president of the country, he wanna order, he wanna carry it out. If the order is not that important, he call his secretary or whatever it is and tell her that, call this minister and give him such and such. If the thing is important, he pick up the phone and call the prime minister or the minister, listen, do this, do that. But if the thing is dead seriously, what he does? He called the minister to come and meet him in his office. Imagine if you're working right now and your boss, he said he wants you in his office. Your mind will rush crazy. What's going on? What's happening? And when you go and he give you an order, you will make sure that order has to be done correctly, because if it wasn't important, they will never call you to the office. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala pick up and call Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to go to the seven heaven. And we all know the stories that when he went there and Jibreel stopped and Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went and they gave him 50 salah and he came out and he had Musa alayhi salam and he'd been back and forth between Musa and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala till they make the salah from 50 to 5. At the end he said, Musa, he said, go alayhi salam, go back because this is too much. He said, I shy. They gave me 5 salah with the reward of the 50. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in that situation, he asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Ya Allah, you brought me all the way here to give me the zakah, the salah. He said, Ya Muhammad, yes. Na'am Muhammad. He said, why you didn't bring my ummah with me to know and show? And then they know that the importance of the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answered Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam back. He said, Ya Muhammad, I gave you something in your hand. If you take it to your ummah down in the ground and they stick with it, it will elevate them, it would elevate all of them to the seven heaven. This is the salah in our hand. Some people, I have a lot of friends, they tell you that, listen, we are busy. We can't pray, do all the pray. We come at night, I'm a doctor. I go in an operation 3, 4, 5 hours, I can't pray. My questions, you know, I asked them, I said, listen, if you are in the middle of the operation and the nature called, what do? Start laughing. No, don't laugh. What do? Say, we go. I said, okay, if you're going for 5 times, 5 minutes to do this, you have 5 minutes to pray. And you believe Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is the one that's ordered us to do salah. He will order with something that we cannot do it. When he comes, he make an exception in the salah. If you need the time from the fajr all the way to the maghrib, you have to cut the salah in half. Al-zuhr 2 rak'ah, al-asr 2 rak'ah, and you pray them all the way close to the maghrib. Jam'at akhir. And you have the time from the morning all the way to the maghrib. No, if you need the time before, you pray the asr and zuhr in the zuhr time, 2 rak'ah, 2 rak'ah, and you have the time from asr all the way to the maghrib. And from there, you could pray the maghrib and the isha together, you have the time all the way there. This is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one He has created us. He knows exactly how to handle it. People, they tell you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order every and each soul with whatever that soul is capable of. This is my capability. This is your capability to go like that. No. You are understanding the ayah wrong, in a wrong way. Don't take your capability and make it that fits in the order of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's the other way around. You have, if Allah, in a plain word, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us with something, that's we capable of being doing it. Bottom line, like that. And it's a little reminder right here. We always, as a human being, this is for me, myself, and for my brothers. You, all of us, we make mistakes. And all of us, we khata'un. Before you go one step further, ask yourself a question. You want to put yourself in Adam's side or in Iblis' side, the shaitan's side, wal-iyazu billah. Both Adam alayhi salam and Iblis, they make mistakes. Adam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgave him. Iblis, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chased him away from his mercy. Despite that, the mistake of Adam alayhi salam was bigger than the mistake of Iblis. How? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell Adam, don't go close to this tree. But at the same time, he has all kind of the tree, including that tree that he ate from it. And it's only one order Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave it to Adam. And that order was directly between him and Adam. And Adam went and ate. Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell Adam, don't eat from the tree? No. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا يَا آدَمُ اسْكُنْ أَنْتَ وَزَوْجُكَ الْجَنَّةِ وَلَا تَقْرَبَا هَذِهِ الشَّجَرَةِ. Don't come close to this tree. Not done eat. He went close and he passed and he trespassing and he ate. Despite that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive him. Come to the Iblis. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ. In another ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا إِبْلِيسَ كَانَ مِنَ الْجِنِّ. The order was direct to the malaika to do the sujood for Adam, not for Iblis. Iblis was among the malaika. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said Iblis wasn't from the malaika. It was from the jinn. Then if Iblis, he said, oh Allah, Allah asked him, why you didn't do the sujood? If he said, I thought that the order is for the malaika, I'm not from the malaika, it will be done. But bring in an excuse. And believe it or not, some people, they believe on this excuse. And they go with it. You are arguing, bringing excuses, and trying to take the order back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will go to the Iblis side. But admitting that you make a mistake, repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Go back, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept you. This is how it goes. So we make sure that don't get an excuse. Don't try to get something and believe on it and take yourself to Jahannam. وَالْعِيَازُ بِاللَّهِ. Try to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And back to the salah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala order us to do a special kind of the salah in the war time. Believe it, on the war time. If what's tough and what's going to be harsh more than a war time, in the war time while you're fighting the enemy, you have to pray. What's going to be tougher than this? Because of that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, من استطاع منكم فليصلي واقفا فإن لم يستطع فليصلي جالسا. If you can't, stand up when you're praying. If you can't, pray while you're sitting, كما قال الحبيب. If you can't, pray while you're laying down, كما قال الحبيب. If you can't, pray with your eye, pray with your finger. Do the pray things in your heart. There is no way the salah is going to leave you. And you have to leave. No way. And somebody come and ask, in the war and while I'm sick, should I pray? Yes. You have to be smart. This is the time we all the time need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the most time that we need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you're sick and when you're fighting the enemy. So you're going to make the reason that you need Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. The reason that you're going to leave Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you're sick, believe it or not, we all the time in our life, we live with the blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But sometimes, we live with the blesser itself, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you're sick, not me, not anybody is going to be sitting beside you. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he will be sitting beside you. Leave, forget about all the ni'mah, all the blessing. The blesser himself is sitting beside you. What man want more than this? أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. الحمد لله وكفى والصلاة والسلام على عبده المصطفى. قيل في الأثر الحديث أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أتاه جبريل. جبريل came to رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم and he was crying. جبريل asked رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, يا رسول الله السلام يقرئك السلام. الله سبحانه وتعالى saying سلام عليكم and ask you while he knows why are you crying. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يا جبريل من لأمتي من بعدي. Who is going to be for my nation after me? Jibril, he silent for a little bit and he said, Ya Muhammad, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling you that isn't satisfied for you. A quarter of the Jannah people is going to be from your nation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no. Jibreel, he said, isn't satisfied for you. Half of the Jannah people is from your nation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no. He said, isn't satisfied for you. Two-thirds of the Jannah people is going to be from your nation. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, no. I will never be satisfied till the last one of my nation be out of the hellfire. Then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrated, then I saw a scene of the day of the judgment. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a voice from a side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala came and he said, take out from the hellfire everyone said la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah. Take out everyone from the hellfire has a little drop of iman inside of him. If that was like a head of a pin, then they took those people out of the hellfire. They said the Jannah people, when they look at those people, they said, those are the people of the hellfire. He said, وَنَادَى مُنَادٍ مِّن قِبَلِ اللَّهِ, a voice came from the side of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He said, dip these people on a river called a life river. They said that they dipped those people in the river and they took them out. He said, when the Jannah people, they saw those people, they said, those are the people that went to the Jannah before us. Subhanallah. Here, they said the ayah saying, Ya laytani takhastu ma'ar rasooli sabila came on. The ayah that saying that the kuffar, they're saying, I wish if I was take away if it's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, read. This is the rahmah from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahumma arhamar rahmin, aghfir lana dhunubana wa kaffir anna sayyatina wa tawaffana ma'al abrar. Allahumma arhamar rahmin, aj'ala khayra ayyamina yawma liqaik wa khayra a'malina khawatimaha wa akhtim bilbaghiyati salihati a'malina. اللهم استرنا فوق الأرض وتحت الأرض ويوم العرض عليك يا أرحم الراحمين. ربنا لا تجعلنا ذنبا في هذا اليوم العظيم إلا غفرته, ولا ذنبا إلا ولا دينا إلا قضيته, ولا هما إلا فرجته, ولا كربا إلا فرجته, ولا مريضا إلا شفيته, ولا ميتا إلا رحمته, ولا ضالا إلا هديته, ولا حاجة من حوائج الدنيا لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاح إلا قضيتها برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم ارحم ميتنا هذا رحمة واسعة, واغسل خطاياه بالماء والثلج والبرد, ونقي من خطاياه كما ينقى الثوب الأبيض من الدنس, واجعل اطرح البركة في أهله وذريته يا أرحم الراحمين, وارحم موتانا وموت المسلمين أجمعين. عباد الله, إن الله يعمل بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. اذكروا الله الكريم يذكركم, واشكروه على آلائه يزدكم, وقوموا إلى صلاتكم يرحمكم الله.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والعصر, إن الإنسان لفي خسر, إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر.